Welcome to Breast Cancer Breakthroughs. In 1987, researchers discovered the biomarker HER2, and this dramatically revolutionized the landscape of breast cancer treatment. Since then, there has been an explosion in HER2-targeting drugs, which have dramatically improved outcomes for people with HER2-positive breast cancer. Despite all of our progress, there is still so much work to be done because breast cancer can outsmart even our most advanced therapies. Today, we will give you the latest in breast cancer research news and talk to you about some advances on the horizon for people with metastatic HER2-positive breast cancer. We'll also talk to you about an exciting clinical trial that has the potential to change the long-standing standard of care for people with metastatic HER2-positive breast cancer for the first time in more than a decade. If you want to learn more about HER2-positive breast cancer or anything that you hear in this episode, check out the links in our description for more information. In our last episode, we told you all about a new antibody-drug conjugate, which was being tested in triple-negative breast cancer, called datopotamab deruxtecan, or Dato-DXd. This was a part of the TROPION-Breast02 trial. A recent press release just announced that there were positive results from the TROPION-Breast01 trial, which is testing Dato-DXd in a metastatic estrogen receptor positive breast cancer setting. We're still waiting to see the final results from the study and looking to see if there will be FDA approval on the horizon, but there may be a new antibody drug conjugate on the way for these patients. We'll continue to update you on Dato-DXd and where this stands as a possible new agent for triple negative breast cancer and other breast cancer types. To learn more about Dato-DXd and triple negative breast cancer, check out our last episode on the unmet needs for TNBC. A recent press release announced promising results for a new diagnostic test for early HER2-positive breast cancer. This new test, called HER2-DX, is designed to predict whether a person's cancer will return after their initial treatment, which is called recurrence. This can help doctors decide which patients should have a more aggressive course of therapy that includes chemotherapy, and it helps to identify those who can safely skip chemotherapy along with the side effects that come with it, which is a strategy known as treatment de-escalation. This test is not currently included in breast cancer treatment guidelines in the U.S., but we'll keep you informed if this changes. To learn more about treatment de-escalation strategies and the HER2-DX test, check out the links in our description. And now for our featured topic. HER2 is not only a biomarker for an aggressive type of breast cancer, but it's also a protein that can cause breast cancer cells to grow. We asked Dr. Ian Krop, an expert in HER2-positive breast cancer and Komen Scholar alumni, exactly how HER2 works to drive breast cancer.
HER2 is a protein that's on the surface of all cells. It's a normal protein. And what HER2 does is when a cell is under stress, it activates the cell to grow more quickly and kind of be stronger. And what happens in about 15 or 20% of breast cancers is that while the cancer is developing, it has a mutation or an alteration in one of the genes, the DNA of the cell, that leads to dramatic overexpression of this HER2 protein. So a normal cell might have 1,000 HER2 proteins on the surface, and a HER2 positive cell will have 1 million of these HER2 proteins. So these cells are really just covered in this HER2 protein. And as I mentioned, the function of HER2 is to tell the cell to grow more quickly and to be stronger. And so when you have 1 million of these proteins all telling the cell to grow more quickly, the cell grows more quickly. So without treatment, a HER2 positive breast cancer tends to be a little bit more aggressive than a cancer that's not HER2 positive. But around in the late 1990s, it was realized that the reason these cancers behave more aggressively is because of this HER2 protein, and that led to the development of drugs that block that HER2 protein.
The first HER2 targeting treatment is called trastuzumab, or Herceptin, and this was approved in 1998. Since then, there has been a stunning amount of progress in HER2 targeting treatments. Researchers have built on this momentum, and we now have a total of 8 drugs that all target HER2. Countless clinical trials have been conducted that have helped us to move the needle to understand when to give each of these different drugs to the right person at the right time. With all of this progress, you might be wondering, why is HER2-positive breast cancer still a problem? We asked Dr. Krop what the biggest issues are that researchers and doctors are trying to solve for HER2-positive breast cancer.
There still is a couple things that we really would like to improve upon. And so one is that while we have 8 different HER2-directed drugs, all of which have effectiveness, there are some patients who eventually their cancer becomes resistant to all of those different treatments. So there's always room for drugs that can reverse this thing called therapy resistance. So cancers evolve, they can change and evolve over time to become resistant to our drugs, just like, you know, just like bacteria can become resistant to antibiotics. And so we switch from one drug to another. But what we really hate to happen is when we kind of run out of effective therapies for a specific patient. So one challenge that we need to work on is coming up with drugs that overcome this resistance in patients. And you know, that's something that we're always working on, and there's a lot of work being done in that area. So that's one thing. And the other one that's really that can be a challenge is when HER2-positive breast cancer travels to the brain. And it does this not uncommonly for reasons that we don't completely understand, but we do know that patients with HER2-positive advanced breast cancer can develop metastases to the brain. And we have effective therapies. Radiation can work very well in that situation. But in some patients, even after radiation, the cancer can come back in the brain. And we have some drugs that work in that area. Tucatinib is one. It does appear that some of these antibody drug conjugates like trastuzumab deruxtecan or Enhertu also can work in the brain. But, you know, there clearly is a opportunity to get even better therapies for brain metastases. And, you know, a lot of work is being done in that area.
If you're interested in learning more about how HER2 targeting therapies work, check out the link for this video. Dr. Krop also spoke with us about the latest research in advanced HER2-positive breast cancer that he thinks is really exciting right now.
Again, it's an exciting field. There's a lot of things going on. Of course, we would not have made any progress without patients participating in clinical trials. And there are a number of trials going on now that you know, people are excited about the results as they start to come out. There's a trial called KATE3, which is combining TDM1 or Kadcyla, the antibody drug conjugate, with a drug that activates the immune system. This is a drug called atezolizumab, which is a mouthful, but it's a drug that is designed to kind of reactivate and wake up a person's immune system so that immune system can go help fight the cancer in addition to the TDM1. That's a trial that, you know, I think we're excited about because these immune therapies have been very effective in other kinds of breast cancer, not yet shown to be effective in HER2-positive breast cancer. But so this will be a trial that's asking that question. There's other combinations combining tucatinib, which is a oral inhibitor of HER2. It's already used in combination with trastuzumab and capecitabine in patients who've had a number of lines of therapy. But the idea with tucatinib is now being tested is whether you combine it with other drugs like TDM1 or like pertuzumab and trastuzumab as a way to make the effectiveness of tucatinib even stronger. So there's two different trials, HER2-CLIMB-02, which is combining tucatinib with TDM1, and HER2-CLIMB-05, which is combining tucatinib with pertuzumab and trastuzumab in that first line THP regimen after patients have finished the chemotherapy part. Both of those have very good laboratory data to say that those combinations should be effective. So I think everybody's optimistic and hopeful that the trials are going on are going to show that tucatinib is beneficial in those settings. And then lastly, was trying to improve that first line THP regimen to find something better. So as I said, HER2-CLIMB-05 is asking whether adding tucatinib will improve the effectiveness. Destiny Breast 09 is a trial that's substituting the taxane and Herceptin Perjeta regimen for a different regimen using that TDXD or trastuzumab deruxtecan and HER2 antibody drug conjugate. You know, in HER2 has shown really remarkable effectiveness in patients who've already had at least one HER2 therapy. So I think looking at it in the first line, so meaning that for newly diagnosed patients, is a area that you know, I think people are also optimistic will show, you know, even more efficacy. So again, even though THP is very effective and works well for a long time in most patients, there's still room for improvement, and perhaps using HER2 in that setting will show that kind of even higher level of effectiveness and duration of treatment that, you know, we all are looking for, so that patients don't have to change therapies very often.
One of the trials Dr. Krop mentioned is the HER2-CLIMB-05 trial. And this is one of many exciting ongoing trials for people with advanced HER2-positive breast cancer. If the HER2-CLIMB-05 trial is successful, this will replace the standard of care regimen that has been used in the first-line setting for more than 10 years. We spoke with Dr. Ciara O'Sullivan, a member of the HER2-CLIMB-05 steering committee, to tell us more about what the gap is that this trial is trying to fill for patients.
Yeah, that's a great question. So the gap that the HER2-CLIMB-05 trial is trying to fill for patients, it is really that the standard of care for first-line metastatic HER2-positive breast cancer has remained the same since 2012, and is currently a chemotherapy drug called Taxol, combined with trastuzumab or Herceptin, and pertuzumab or Perjeta. And after patients complete chemotherapy, they continue Herceptin and Perjeta as long as their cancer remains stable. And although this is effective treatment, most patients develop progression of disease and maintenance therapy. Further, up to 50% of all patients with HER2-positive metastatic breast cancer unfortunately develop brain metastases. Therefore, more effective treatment and prevention is needed. So studying drugs which can prevent or reduce the development of brain metastases is very important in HER2-positive metastatic breast cancer. In HER2-CLIMB-05, we are testing whether adding a drug called tucatinib to maintenance therapy with trastuzumab and pertuzumab can stabilize cancer for a longer period of time and improve quality of life compared with maintenance therapy alone. As tucatinib is already known to improve disease stability and overall survival, and or can delay the development of brain metastases in women who have received several treatments for HER2-positive metastatic breast cancer, it is thought that patients receiving their first-line therapy for HER2-metastatic disease could also benefit.
We know that brain metastasis is a major issue for people with HER2-positive breast cancer, and we just heard exciting news from Dr. O'Sullivan that tucatinib may delay the development of brain metastasis. We asked Dr. O'Sullivan why it is so important to find new treatments to prevent and target brain metastases.
Yeah, so I think you're right. It's such an important question. I mean, I think we're doing so well in HER2-positive breast cancer with so many new agents, so many new FDA approvals. Patients are living longer. However, patients still develop brain metastases, and they can be really difficult to treat, and they can compromise morbidity and mortality. So I think newer treatments that can prevent brain metastases to begin with, or more effectively treat existing brain metastases, are really important. So tucatinib, because it really penetrates or gets really effectively into the brain, which not all of the medications that we use to treat HER2-positive breast cancer can do, is really promising in this setting. And we really just hope to prove to reduce this incidence of brain metastases and just get a better handle on the situation.
Dr. O'Sullivan also shared with us what people need to know about the HER2-CLIMB-05 trial.
HER2-CLIMB-05 is a phase 3 trial which will recruit 650 patients with advanced HER2-positive breast cancer in the first-line setting. Patients must have completed 4 to 8 cycles of taxane-based chemotherapy plus trastuzumab and pertuzumab. All patients continue standard maintenance therapy with trastuzumab and pertuzumab once every 3 weeks, as well as hormonal therapy if applicable. Patients will be allocated by a computer to receive either tucatinib or placebo tablets. There is a 50-50 chance of being assigned to either group. Patients take tucatinib or placebo every day, twice daily. Clinic visits are once every 3 weeks, the same time that treatment with trastuzumab and pertuzumab is planned. Research bloods are also collected with standard bloods at the start of cycle through to cycle six of treatment. MRIs and staging scans are required prior to starting on study and are repeated at regular intervals. Questionnaires are administered intermittently to assess quality of life. Patients can continue to receive treatment on the study until their cancer progresses. The main goals of this study are to study the anti-tumor activity of tucatinib combined with trastuzumab and pertuzumab, as well as to determine if the three-drug combination can prevent or slow the development of brain metastases, as well as treat any existing brain metastases.
Dr. O'Sullivan is really excited about what this trial could mean for patients, and she explained to us why.
So I'm personally excited about this clinical trial, as based on the available evidence, I'm hopeful that tucatinib combined with standard maintenance therapy with trastuzumab and pertuzumab will improve disease control and overall survival in patients with HER2-positive advanced breast cancer treated in the first-line setting. I'm really interested to see the outcomes in relation to the prevention and treatment of brain metastases, as an improvement would be a potentially major advance in the treatment of HER2-positive metastatic breast cancer.
Thank you again to our experts, Dr. Krop and Dr. O'Sullivan, for their insightful views on the latest in advanced treatments and clinical trials for HER2-positive breast cancer. We will keep you updated as these trials progress in a future episode of Breast Cancer Breakthroughs. And don't forget to sign up on Komen.org to never miss an episode of Breast Cancer Breakthroughs. Thank you all so much for watching. Here at Komen, we are committed to providing evidence-based information for empowerment on your journey as you navigate the world of breast cancer. And finally, if you enjoyed today's episode, please take 2 minutes to fill out a 2-question questionnaire linked below in our description.